what we don't have in the world that begins to rule us, and that becomes stress. So the moment we focus on Him, the moment we begin to celebrate Him, our life becomes celebration. Being human, we like to be like others. We like to have like others. And by connecting ourselves with the world, we lose sight of what we have in the Lord. We fail to celebrate. That's why the psalmist says, the Lord taught him to say, then call on me in the time of distress, and I will rescue you, and you shall honor me. It will be an experience for you in your moment of stress. When you call upon me in the dark cloud, you will see the white light guiding you. The more we love God, the more we realize our life is a test. Our life is a full of tests. And in the test of fire, we are found worthy. We are found precious. We are found that we prove to the Lord we are His children. Yes, like the gold is put into the fire, most of the time our life is like that. In the book of Genesis, we find how chapter 39, a young man called Joseph was plucked away from his mother as he was a little boy, small boy, not able to even walk. Mother is no more. So he can't even think how his mother would have been. And as he was growing, he was carried away from the father by his own brothers. But God had given him a little light. When he was with his father, one day when he was praying, the Lord gave him a vision that so many stars, and his star came up. And all the other stars are worshipping him. When he was praying and told his daddy, Daddy Jacob, a man of God, a man of vision. He himself had so many visions. So he helped him to interpret, son, you are great. God will raise you one day. God will raise you one day. But the life was not like that. When he went through trials after trials, he may have been wondering, is my dream true? Is my vision true? But the thing is, the beauty in Joseph is he realized, he saw the hand of God. That is the difference. There are so many servants who are going through a problem, but very few make a difference. Why? We read in the book of Genesis, chapter 39, this man, the boy, was now not only removed from the father, and he was sold out. He was sold out in another country where he can't even speak the language of another country. But the Bible says, verse 2, since the Lord was with him, Joseph got on very well. Joseph got on very well. God was with him. Joseph saw. That is very important. Joseph saw the hand of God on him. That is the point. That is the secret. Yes. Like Acts of the Apostles, chapter 4, where we read the high priest and others were wondering, what happened to these fellows? They are not educated guys. They are not educated. And how? They are very bold. They are very bold. How is it possible? They were wondering and they were questioning them. And they were, why? How these people can behave like that? And the secret is written in verse chapter 4, verse 13, observing the boldness of Peter and John and perceiving them to be uneducated guys, ordinary men. But they were amazed and they recognized them as their companions of Jesus, who are with Jesus. The secret is they are uneducated and they are now bold because they were with Jesus. The secret is they were with Jesus. Yes, when you learn to let anything happens, keep your mind on Him. Learn to be with Him. Learn to move with Him. And it is there if we find our new joy, our courage to face life. Amidst dark clouds, God sets the silver lines. And we need to notice that and move on in life. Move on in life. When the people of Israel, where they were moving, they were walking with their feet. The enemies were coming with horses and chariots. But they never met together. In between was just the clouds of the Lord. So they come forward. Suddenly the horse see the dark cloud, they fall. Once few horses fall, all the chariots get stopped. When they find some carts, some chariots are broken. So they have to get up, fast, do this, do that, that repairing, all that. By the time those people went away, half kilometers. They were coming with the chariots. That's why beautiful word of the Lord says in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 10, verse 23, Lord, I know that the life of man is not in his hands. And whatever he does, I know no man can guide his life. I know, Lord. That's why in Jeremiah chapter 9, verse 23, Jeremiah could experience he was simply mistrusted by people. His own people threw him into a well and allowed him to die. They never bothered about him. But he trusted in God. He was not a man who did not know the truth. So he didn't look at the world. He did not look at his own people, so-called his own people, and begin to say, everybody left me. Why these things have happened to me? Why should I live? No. When we look at the world, when we identify ourselves with the people of this world, we may think like that. If the moment we learn to know the truth, we learn to identify ourselves with the Lord, we learn to identify ourselves with the mission of the Lord has sent me for a mission, our life and our thinking changes. Satan's goal is not to lift us up, so he will tie us up with the world. So what the world thinks of you, what you think of the world, how will you face the world? Why should you face? You are a king, you are a queen. Whether you are alone or whether you are together, whether you are more than together, doesn't matter. You as an individual is the gift of God. You are sent with a mission. Yes. And that's why we find in the life of Joseph, we find since the Lord was with him, everything went on well. When because of the Lord was with him, the master's favor was on him. Yes. In life we all go through various type of struggles. But as the Israelites, they saw the star, little light that was going before them. Behind them, dark clouds. Before them, little light. Sufficient. The little light of the Lord is greater than sufficient enough to face the dark clouds of the enemy. the little light of Christ is sufficient to dispel the thickest darkness of the enemy. So what matters is, the moment we begin to gaze on the light that Lord shows, we can pass through the darkness of this world. That's why Paul said, it is no longer I who live, but the Lord lives in me. Galatians 2:20.